Hello, Keith. Just want to wish you good luck with the future. For how many years you've been here, you've been doing a great job sitting behind this desk, and it's not my turn, but whoever comes next has some big shoes to fill. So we just want to thank you for your service to the Manhattanville community, and good luck in the future.
Keith, I just want to say I'm really going to miss you. I'm going to miss our phone calls late in the afternoon when we talk about a student-athlete issue that both you and I are surprised about. I'm going to miss a lot of things about you, Keith, but most importantly, I'm going to miss your smile, I'm going to miss your personality, and I'm just going to miss you. So again, I wish you the best of luck in all your future endeavors.
Goodbye and good luck!
Keith, it has been an absolute pleasure working for you these past few years. You have been a mentor to me not only at work, but in my life outside of work as well. I don't know who I'm going to miss more, you or Piper.
Definitely Piper.
In all seriousness, you have been an amazing boss, and Sidwell is very, very lucky to have you. Congratulations again, and best of luck.
I'm gonna miss you, but I'm gonna miss Piper more. Best of luck.
Hey Keith, just want to say thank you for everything you've done for the college and the department, and certainly for me specifically. You hired me and you supported me through everything, and I'm really grateful to you. And personally, I'm excited that Noon Basketball will go back to being just basketball and not a mix of hockey and basketball, and the safety of our coaches will be the priority once again. So we'll miss you in every other phase of it, but not there. So thank you for everything. You've been great, and we wish you the best of luck.
I've known you since I was a student athlete. You're one of the first people I got to meet on campus. I still remember when I came here as an international student athlete, you were our head hockey coach and I was introduced to you, and soon we started to see more of each other as I grew to be a senior. And I think we still joke about the times that you traveled to Elmira with me and the rest of the team, and you were at 100% winning record. But let me remind you, there was a common thread in there. The common thread was I happened to be on that team. And following that, all those years that we still joke about that day that we drove down 5 hours on the way to Elmira, 5 hours on the way back in the same day. I think you had about 25 cups of coffee on Route 17, so it's hard to see you go. I hope Manhattan will continue to be a fond place in your heart. We will surely miss you. I think I say that for everyone. You're a consummate professional, you're a partner, and I think you will continue to do that through the rest of your career.
Keith, you're one of the few who embody the Valiant way, and I just want to say working with you in student affairs throughout the last 13 years of my tenure here, you've really impacted not only athletics and its department and our athletes, but beyond. And I want to say, as a co-worker and a friend, I truly value your input and insight into Manhattanville. I will miss you, the college will desperately miss you, and we need to value what you have given to us through this time. And I just want to say that I wish you the best. Godspeed for you and your family in this new chapter of your life.
Thank you, Keith!
Keith, thank you for your continuous support with Manhattanville Athletics and especially women's ice hockey. We were lucky to have you. Good luck at Sidwell, and we're going to miss you in Piper.
Hey Keith, what can I say? It's been a great run. I think it's been about 14 years ago I went into your office in the fall after our coach had been fired. And I said, hey, the guys want me to run practice, and I hope maybe I can become the head coach. And you said, sure, no problem. And the funny part of that story is I heard after I left your office, you said to the secretary at the time, who the hell was that guy? But, you know, that's the way it goes, you know? You gave me the job, I took it and I ran with it, and I've been here ever since and been having a great time with it. You know, I really miss those times and enjoy watching you when you used to coach, and you were a maniac on the bench, and we had some great teams, and after the games we would go to Rye Bar and Grill and we would have a good time. Those are really some of the best days of this department for sure. Then after that we became friends, and we used to hang out a little bit in Stanford, and that came to a screeching halt one night when we were out and I came back to the apartment and Julian had left my pillow and blanket in the hallway. I guess that meant that either we weren't allowed to hang out together anymore or we had a little bit too much fun. Which leads me to the next thing is I can't believe that you and I both chose Jolene to be the woman running our lives for the past 10 years. I don't know, that we probably both need to get our heads checked about that, because she really, you know, runs your life when you're here, and then we get home, she runs my life at home. So interesting choice by both of us, but I think it's worked out for the best. But I wish you all the best in your future endeavors. It's really been a blast, and I do want to say that to me, one of the best things is that just to watch how you've become such a great leader and now recently watching you become such a great father and husband. And I know you're going to be great at your next job. So thanks and best of luck to you.
Hi, Keith. Congratulations again on your new position. We are really going to miss you, but you know that. You and I already talked about that. When I came to your meeting with the coaches, your orientation meeting with the coaches, and I heard you talk about the Valiant values and what was really important for them, for their students, your interaction with the coaches, I thought that we were on the same page, and I felt that that was confirmed by every interaction we had since then. So I'm really, really very sorry to see you go, although I'm proud of where you're going and what you've done here, the work that you're leaving behind. What we will miss is the wonderful conversations we had about literature, about history, on those drives, and about the program and opportunities for the program. So I wish you all the best. I'm proud of you. We are proud of you. And make sure you send us some students. Thank you, Keith.
Hey, Keith, as a women's hockey player and on behalf of our team, we're very thankful for your continuous support this year. One thing that stood out to us the most was the emails that you always sent us during the year to encourage us and said how proud of you were of us during the school year and during the hockey season.
Keith, I just want to send you my own welcome and thanks and Godspeed. We've worn you out pretty good here since you first came, and one of the first things I recall your bringing to us was the saying about the invention of Manhattanville ice hockey. Nobody said it was going to be easy. Truer words were never spoken. But since I know you're a history guy, and I like that, you're probably familiar with what it says at St. Paul's Cathedral in London with regard to the architect, Christopher Wren. If you seek his monument, look around you. So even though you'll be heading south, we see the monument to your efforts for us everywhere we look, most especially in Kennedy Gym, but not only there. And we thank you for it very much. And stay in touch and come back soon.
So thank you, Keith, for everything you've done for the soccer team and for athletics. Thank you for always keeping your door open to everyone. So you've always been there if we had like an issue or anything. So I want to thank you and wish you good luck with your new adventures.
Keith, I'm here with the maintenance department, as you can see. Just want to say a couple things on your behalf and let you know, of course, that we're going to miss you, number one. Number two, we do have a confession to make that maybe in the beginning when we first got to know you, we were very fond of you. But as time went by, of course, we came to really appreciate you, love you, and respect all that you've done over in athletics. More importantly, from our point of view, one of the things we always appreciate about you is the fact that you and your staff cared about us as a department, were considerate of us, and were always thoughtful of us. And wish you well. We're going to miss you again and again and again.
Hi, Keith. On behalf of men's hockey, I would like to say thank you for all your hard work and continued support. Our team was lucky to have an athletic director who is such an advocate of hockey. I'm glad I got to spend 4 years playing for a program that you created, and I'm looking forward to being a proud alumni. So again, thank you for everything.
So for me, 3 months in, it's incredibly clear to me the impact that you have had on this campus and on the lives of countless students. And so as you make the transition to your next chapter, I say you have left a tremendous legacy.
And for me, I've known you, I think it's been about 15, 16 years. Wow, we're old. But I wish you and your family the best on this new adventure. I will always remember your thoughtful insights, and I will truly miss you. So good luck to you and your family. Farewell.
Hey, Keith. First of all, I want to say congrats on the new job and how much we'll miss you here. But my favorite story is when I went in for my interview to come to Manhattanville 5 years ago, and one of the questions Keith asked me was, you know, if you could be like any head coach, who would you be like? And of course I said Pat Summitt, and he kind of looked at me and he said, really? Because I'm a UConn fan. And I kind of knew from then on that we would always agree to disagree on a few things. But thank you so much for giving a young assistant the opportunity to pursue her dream as a head coach. I've learned a lot and really wish you the best of luck at the next stop of your life.
Thank you, Keith, for everything you've ever done for us. Thank you for driving all the way up to St. John Fisher, for supporting the softball team in our super regional game. It meant a lot to us, and it made it the moment extra special.
There's no one else I would have rather spent the past 15 years with. I'm truly lucky to have you in my corner. I've grown and learned so much from you. You've taught me to be a calm, steady leader and to always make the right choices and to not care what people think. We've shared unbelievable successes both professionally and personally. We've laughed, we've cried. Well, really, it's just me that cries. We've watched each other get married. We've had our baby boys 2 weeks apart. We've watched our team compete for conference championships and national championships together. You even tried to kill me. Too bad for you that rattlesnake was sleeping. But seriously, I am a better person because of you. This department is better because of you. The student athletes are better and lucky to have you fighting for them. I will miss you. Every day, I will miss you. But I won't miss your ridiculous staff development activities. Good luck, and I can't wait to see you in DC.
We do have one request. Even though you're leaving us, please remember, once a Valiant, always a Valiant.
Go Valiants! Go Valiants!
I fell into a burning ring of fire. I went down, 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 and the flames went higher. And it burns, 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 the ring of fire.